meridian line and the zenith. Now, when you say meridian line, it is the line from south to the north that marks the. This is the line from the south to the north that attacks the Earth's, the Sun's, from the attacks the Sun's movement from the sunrise to sunset. Now, that is the meridian line. Now, how about the zenith? Now, the zenith is the middle portion of the meridian line. So, this is the zenith. Now, we are now going to know what is celestial coordinate system. Now, when we say celestial coordinate system, it is a system that is used for specifying positions of celestial objects when are in the sky or in the sky. Now, this celestial coordinate system is slightly bounded to the principle or to the belief of the ancient world that the Earth is the center of the creation. Okay. Now, since it is the center of the creation, therefore they believe that the Earth is motionless. Because it is that. Okay? The Earth is the center of the creation, as I said, and then the sky is a hollow hemisphere arcing over the Earth like a globe. So, in order for you to know or to visualize kung paano nga ba titingnan ng vision yung Earth and the sky, this is how they do it. So this will serve, this part, or the main part, will serve as the Earth. Okay? Now this dome here that covers the Earth will serve as the sky. So therefore, they consider the Earth as the center of the creation. And then the one that is moving is the sky. Okay? Now, these stargazers realize that how does this move up, this Earth move, but then they back about yung mga stars or patterns on the sky. This is how they figure out. So, the dome or the sky dome is actually separated into two parts. The first part is the one that is visible to you during the night time, or the one that is visible during the night time. So, during the night time, the light of the sun will not overflow or will not overflow the sun of the stars. Okay, so you will light the brightness of the stars. So therefore, you're able to see clearly the stars. Now, during the daytime, this is this part, okay? When in the daytime, syempre, the presence of the sun will overpower the light of the stars. So therefore, you are not able to see that part. So, if you are going to view it, now it is divided into two. So for example, this one, we are going to have night and sun. So this part of the sky is the one that you will see. Then the other half is the one that is not visible. Now there are different terms that we need to know in this celestial coordinate system. The first one is the declination. So declination is the angular distance of a point from north or south of the celestial equator. It is labeled as these. Okay? Now, declination, nalalagay sa mapa. So declination is the is equivalent to the latitude of the map. Okay? Kumbaga, the lines or the latitude and the longitude of the map, we are able to keep it kapag lumaki. Then the model is Earth. This is the Earth, and then this is the lights. Now, yung alam na dati, the latitude, will now be called as line of declination or declination when you are talking about celestial coordinate system. Now, this line or declination is measured in degrees. Okay? Now, aside from that, it is also this degree is calculated pieces or bring down to smaller portions which we call as arc minutes. Then arc minutes is now further divided into arc seconds. Okay? Now, this is the celestial equator. So the equator that you know in the map is the celestial. So the celestial equator has what we use for daily degrees, this is the celestial equator. It is zero, okay? So this is the celestial equator, and then after that, the other ones are the night declination. Now, how are we able to know if it's in the north or in the south? Simple. Once that the declination land belongs to the northern part of the equator, that this angle or angle have a positive sign. Okay? That is why the north celestial pole has a positive 90 degree. Okay? Now, those lines that belong to the north part of the celestial equator, these lines has negative degrees. That is why the south celestial pole or the south pole has a negative 90 degree. Is that clear?
Now the astronomy is now
positions of the celestial bodies on the sky. Now, this is what we see. This is now an example of an astrolabe. So, astrolabe, as you can see, is used like that. And then, during consider the stars polaris, okay? Now, they're able to track, they're able to navigate to the right direction where they want to go to astrolabe. Now, here are the ones that we need to keep in mind for us to know or how to use the planning sphere. Now, can you bring up the planning sphere?
Yes.
Okay. So, if there are any questions, just raise your hands. So, what are you doing? The first step is you take the star wheel of the planning sphere to a point where the current time and day could be. For example, our time is latitude 4. The day and day is January 16th. So in your star wheel, this is the star wheel. Find January 16th. Then the 9th, exactly 4:25 p.m. So I have in 4:25 p.m. Medyo dito sa baba, so medyo hindi makikita. Ibay naman natin yung copy yung oras, okay? Pwede natin sabihin na 9 p.m. Gawin natin yung 9 p.m. So January 16, 9 p.m. Pakita pa.
You can have synchronized that there is solarium. That's the solarium mountain. Okay, so you might as well use the real-time today so that you can see if it is really the stars that you will see in your stellarium, because it is
correct.
Huh?
You verify it. You now, for example, we are checking in January 16, 9 p.m. So, as you can see, these patterns that you will see here in the real-time pattern, these are the constellations that you will see in the sky. So, paano malalaman kung saan the north, south, or east, and west? So, first, the next step is you have to go outside on the direction where you are facing. For example, since this is the part where the Manila Bay is, so we will consider this as west. Okay? Now, since you are going to see or observe the western part of the sky, so you will need to place this transphere towards the west and hold it like that. And then you will see all the constellations. Give me one constellation. Open up the top. Pisces, Gulay, other constellation. Aries, Taurus, Pegasus, and Andromeda. Okay? Pareho ba? Gumawa ba? Yes. So those are the constellations that you will see in the western part of the sky in the 9 p.m. Okay? Yung cloud. Now, retake the whole time as people na sinabi ko sa inyo kanina, rotate nyo papuntang west para mas madaling malaman if that constellation belongs to the western part of the sky. Step 4, if finding an unfamiliar star, for example, you want to find an unfamiliar star or a constellation, start by finding a bright star or a familiar constellation. For example, you want to find a specific star. You don't know the name of that star. So, nakita mo yan, dyan, star. Remember, star muna tayo, okay? Because when we are going to determine the planets, you are not able to see know the position of the planet you see this because the planets are constantly moving. Okay, so stars now. For example, we're going to find an unfamiliar star. So first, find a familiar star or a familiar constellation. So once you find a familiar constellation, for example, you can tell that your familiar constellation is Orion. Okay. Pag-hanap So you're able to know the what star is that sa left side ng Orion's belt pag nahanap mo yung Orion. So therefore, you're able to know or be the star or the particular star that you want to know. Now another one is find an adjacent constellation in the direction of the new object. So tulad nito kanina, titingnan niyo to verify more. Titingnan pa kayo ang relevant constellation. Then what was nakita mo or constellation na yon sa gilid or sa adjacent ang familiar star at familiar constellation that you want to go. You're able to verify the constellation or the star that you want. Look at the sky and identify the star that you want to know. For example, Vega. So you're able to know kung saan yung Vega. Sa pamamagitan ng paghahanap ng familiar constellation na malaki sa Vega. Now, the next product is what we call stellarium.
Now the stellarium is the more high-tech, a star or a celestial object. Now, we will verify later the stars we found.
What I'm asking here is Now, can we bring out the stellarium that we have in goals?
Or
say something on Mars?
Saturn.
Yeah.
Saturn.
If you will choose landscape, for example, the Saturn, so it will show you a model of a landscape of the Saturn. For example, that one is filled with gas clouds.
Thank you.
bumanga pa rin, yata pa rin, wala pa rin tinatawag na anong gagawin. Kung ayaw mo lang, di kayo interesado sa klase dito, you may step out of your room, and now you can go out. One! Lahat na ayaw lumabas na, lahat na gusto maiwan. Isa! Lahat na walang ginagawa, lahat na walang trabaho. Ako nga, guru na, ayan o. O, ito na. Meron! And what about those? Stay outside, if you don't want to, be with us. At the count of God, you are not still out, I will send you out, and you will not be in our class anymore. One. Ayun tumabaho. Two. Erica, where's your work? Where's your cell phone? Oh, anong gagawin mo sa cell phone mo? Tatago mo? Oh, bakit mo na? Alam mo naman na dapat yan, pinapa-install. Kailan ko po yan pinapa-install sa inyo? Ngayon lang ba?
Earth Science Teacher, if you click this, it will show the equatorial grid. Now, here na equatorial grid, it is better if you look at this display. Yan, or outward. Yan, pero better pag naka-inward para mas kita. Then, you can see there the degrees, which is the declination, and so as the right ascension over there. So, if you can see the icon here, Venus, nakita ba? You try to look at it. It is in the western part, and you can also see the sun setting. Now, Venus there is at the. It is.
Yeah. take a look at these stars, and you will be seeing these stars.
So now we have here the western part. So let's see if there is a Taurus there. So there is Taurus. Can you see it?
Can you please verify it?
Yes,
the time is in the 4th century AD. Now, you manipulate that for will be used in the field of astronomy, particularly your interest in star gazing, meron na passive.
So now we have shown you the two products that we have, and we assume that you know which one is more precise and which one is the more which one is easier to use. Now we're in the technology phase.
So we were look at this. If you want to start this, we will suggest that you will use the Stellarium. You can install the Stellarium on your phones and laptops.
Yes.
So I want to see this one. It's a bit about that one. You can probably get the version of the screen. Now, what I'm showing you is the constellations.
So,
to sum it all up,
so this is the power button.
Power button, but I'm going to see that. So for our summary, so here is the summary. First, celestial coordinate. Celestial coordinate is a system used by astronomers to specify positions of celestial objects in the sky. Now, it originates from the belief of the ancient that the Earth is the center of the universe, or the center of the creation, and what it is constantly moving is the sky. Now, there are four terms that you will encounter in the celestial coordinate. The first one is the azimuth, and the directions around the horizons. So these are the north, east, west, and south. Then followed by the altitude, or the angle of stars, stars or objects from the horizon. Then after that is the meridian line. As I said, is the line that maps the that's the path of the sun from the sunrise to the sunset. Okay? And in the middle of the meridian line, there you are, that is what we call the zenith. On the map. So the celestial coordinates to them is labeled as declination.
Now there